Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the operation of RSVP traffic engineering in an MPLS-TE topology. I'm passionate about breaking down complex telecom and networking topics into simple, clear explanations. My goal is to make learning these concepts as simple as possible, just the way I wish someone had done for me when I was starting out. If you enjoyed this approach, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon to catch all of my latest content. In a couple of previous videos, we took a look at the components required to deploy MPLS-TE. These included enabling MPLS-TE on all relevant interfaces, enabling OSPF-TE on the MPLS topology, configuring RSVP-TE on all our P and PE routers, and creating an MPLS-TE tunnel on our ingress LSP router. Now, in this video, we'll be taking a closer look at the operation of RSVP-TE. What kinds of messages are exchanged between RSVP-TE routers, and how do they reserve and free up resources when a tunnel is created or is torn down? And how does RSVP interact with the underlying IGP in all of this? Well, let's take a look. Now, for our tunnel here, let's assume that our setup has selected the path via PE1, P1, P2, and PE2 to establish our MPLS-TE tunnel. All of these routers have been enabled with RSVP-TE. As such, each router keeps track of two particular states, the path state and the reservation state. Now, the path state keeps track of various parameters of the path itself. These parameters are stored within a data structure in each RSVP-enabled router called the path state block, or the PSB. Information contained within the PSB include the route calculated by the constrained SFP algorithm that was run by the underlying IGP, as well as the IP addresses of the head-end and tail-end routers and the tunnel ID. As signaling messages are sent from router to router, information from those signaling messages are stored within the PSB of each router. Thus, each router maintains up-to-date information about the path state. Now, the reservation state is another set of information that is stored within another data structure called the reservation state block, or the RSB. The RSB keeps track of reserved resources for each TE tunnel. For each interface configured with RSVP, a resource reservation state is contained within the RSB. Now, the PSB and the RSB are populated using information that is obtained from two specific RSVP messages, arguably the most important messages sent by this protocol. They are the path message and the reservation message. The path message is generated by the head-end router and is sent to the tail-end router. Its purpose is to request the reservation resources from every router along the path. The reserved values are those configured in the parameters of the created MPLS-TE tunnel interface. The actual path taken by the path message is based on the path computed by the CSPF algorithm within our head-end router. Each router along the path, and indeed each interface that has been configured with RSVP along the path, will receive this message and will check availability of the requested resources. In addition, this path message is used to request an MPLS label for the TE tunnel we want to establish. Now, the reserve message is generated by the tail-end router as a response to the path message. This response is essentially a confirmation that the requested reservation has been achieved. Since the path message reached the tail end successfully, the reservation has been successful on all routers along the path. Now, the reservation message also responds to the request for MPLS labels found within the initial path message. The actual label mapping for the whole TE tunnel begins with the reservation message as it is forwarded upstream from the tail end to the head end router. Each upstream router performs label mapping until the head-end router is reached. Now, these path and reservation messages are refreshed periodically as part of the RSVP's operation to maintain the session and reservations. Now, beyond the path and reservation messages, we also have a few more RSVP messages that participate in this whole operation. We have the path error and the reservation error messages. As their names suggest, these are used to deal with errors that may be encountered in the exchange of path and reservation messages. The path error message is sent by a router in response to a received path message that it cannot process or comprehend. This message is sent in the upstream direction towards the head end router that originated the path message. A path error message can be triggered by various conditions, including unrecognized or invalid information in the path message, inability to allocate the requested resources, or an invalid or infeasible path specification. Now, the path error message contains error information, such as an error code and error values, to help diagnose the error. Depending on the error type and the RSVP configuration, the path error message may also result in a complete removal of the RSVP state for the corresponding session. Now, the reserve error message is similar in function, but works in the opposite direction, and it's a response to the reserve message that is either incomprehensible or contains incorrect information. The reserve error message is always directed downstream towards the tail end router, which initiated the initial reservation message. Now, two more messages that are used by RSVP are the PathTear and the ResvErr message. The PathTear message is used to remove the path state. This typically occurs when the head end router decides to tear down a tunnel or when the path state expires due to a timeout. Upon receiving this message, a router releases the allocated bandwidth, making it available for other reservations, and updates that information in its PSB. The PathTear message travels downstream, following the same path as the original path message towards the tail end router. Now, the PathTear messages are actually not mandatory. You can allow a tunnel to simply expire due to its timeout. If a head end router doesn't need a tunnel anymore, it can simply stop sending path messages. By default, such a timeout is set to 30 seconds. However, PathTear messages help accelerate network convergence rather than waiting for that timeout to expire. The ResvErr message is essentially the response to the PathTear message. It is generated by the tail end router and travels upstream towards the head end router following the reverse path of the PathTear message. It's used to remove the reservation state, and each router along the path ensures that the RSB is updated accordingly. So you can see RSVP uses all of these messages to create, maintain, and tear down paths while reserving the appropriate amounts of bandwidth at each interface along the way. That way, you have a guaranteed path as well as guaranteed resources for that path between the head end and tail end router. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you have any questions or feedback, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. I'm always happy to read them and to respond. And please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.